से जैम नहीं हुआ तो अभी तो टीआईएफएफ तो दूर की बात है।
So, hi Sulangna, we have
Hello,
our
sir.
PhD selected student, integrated PhD selected student for TIFR. And I would like to ask you, first of all, beginning with your introduction, please introduce yourself.
Hello, I'm Sulangna Datta. I pursued my BSc from St. Xavier's College, Kolkata, BSc Physics Honours. Then I gave JAM, but my JAM rank was not too good. And I got selected in TIFR, so now I will be pursuing my integrated PhD from TIFR, Mumbai.
Okay, so can you tell you about like how was you were a student in your BSc days, like how you used to be in your BSc?
Okay, in my BSc, I was like, I won't say I was too good in my BSc level. I was an average student, okay. I was not too good, like I was not a topper, like I was always getting very good marks and all. But yeah, like in my core subjects, I was good. Not all the core subjects. I was a bit bad in, poor in classical mechanics. I didn't like that subject. I don't know why. But in other subjects, I was okay. Like not bad.
Very important point for someone, you know, many students have this kind of, you know, feel that, yaar, main toh achha nahi hu BSc level mein. Kya main JAM crack kar paunga? Ya main TIFR crack kar paunga? No, students have this doubt. So you basically cleared that doubt ki, yaar, if you are not very good in BSc, still you can go for, you know, entrance exam and crack it.
Like your basics should be clear. That's the only thing. You should know your subject. It doesn't matter how much marks you get. You should know the subject.
Okay. So following on that, I would like to ask your experience for TIFR written exam.
Okay. So for TIFR written exam, I didn't do anything specially for TIFR. Whatever preparation I took was for JAM only. Okay, so I started my preparation exactly 6 months before JAM. The time you started teaching. Before that, I was like I didn't do much. I didn't take much pressure. But then the time you started teaching and you say that there's only 6 months left, all this, like you say this number of days is only left. You have to, like, now you have to start. You should start. So at that time I was like, yes, I have to start now. So I did start 6 months earlier. And I used to watch your lectures recorded. I never did the live lectures because I used to hear those lectures in 2x speed. I don't waste much time. So, for TIFR, I didn't do anything like else. Before TIFR, after giving JAM, when I saw that, I should say what I did in JAM now. Okay, so I prepared for JAM and I knew that my preparation was good. It was not bad. Okay. Even in fact, in your tests also, I used to score good marks.
Yeah, I noticed.
So I was like yes. So
whenever so I used like, to get the forms, I noticed, yeah, you are scoring a good marks. Like
yes, and I used to practice a lot. So yeah. I was like, okay, I think I will secure good marks in JAM. I like this was in my mind, but like on the day of the exam, I don't know why that happened. I knew that my MSQ part was not good for JAM. So I have to secure my marks from MCQ and NAT. So,
okay.
Like I knew that
it
my
happens.
Exam was
you
very
know,
bad.
You know, one day cannot judge your knowledge and, you know, study. But and that you proved. Like if JAM is not clear, you didn't give up. You cleared the TIFR exam, and that is so good.
So yes, sir. So but still it was in my mind that okay, I could not do good in JAM. That means I will not do good in TIFR also. So this was in my mind, but still like I knew that, okay, but I should go prepared. So I started doing the last year papers before TIFR. I did JEST and TIFR last year papers. All the papers I did them and then I go for the exam. And but one thing was that while giving the TIFR exam, I was not at all tensed. I was not nervous. That was one thing that happened. And I think that helped me.
Yeah, that
So
helps.
I
Definitely, I can also remember my time when I gave TIFR and JAM exam. I was very, very relaxed. I was like, even after 1 hour of, writing my exam, I got a walk. Like I should walk for 5 minutes. I wasted my 5 minutes and got a walk in IIT JAM exam, in mid of the exam, because I want some relaxation. It's okay. Being relaxed is the key. And as you said, I pointed three things. Like, you covered JAM exam syllabus. That was enough for TIFR. And
yes.
You practiced previous year question and you were relaxed.
Yes.
So these three
yes.
things majorly
yes.
worked for you.
Yes.
Okay.
So I was
Let's talk
relaxed.
About your TIFR, the interview thing, interview part, how
yes.
it went and what were the procedure
so,
and how it went.
Yes. So before interview, like after I got the result, there was a gap of at least a month. Okay. So
mm-hmm.
I got a lot of time to prepare for my interview. So like for interview, see, for MCQs, we generally do not, go through the entire book. We just, solve problems and okay, it's done. So for interview, I knew that I have to go through the book once. So like I took these four subjects, quantum, statmic, EMT and heat and thermodynamics. I read the entire books. For quantum, I read Griffiths totally. Then
oh, wow.
I also read some of little of Zettli also, because I like quantum. That is one thing, I like quantum. Then
that's so good,
for
yeah.
Yes. So then for EMT, I read Griffiths again, and I solved the examples also. I solved
okay.
some examples and the exercise, some questions, not all the questions, but some I did. Then
okay.
for statmic, I didn't read Rife totally. I did not totally, but upar se thoda par liya. And because same 6 mein mera statmic tha. So
mm-hmm.
uske liye, from college, the notes I got, I read all those notes. So it was okay. But, so I prepared for my interview also and I prepared for my exam also. So for statmic, I did it in that way. And for heat and thermodynamics, I read Garg, Bansal and Ghosh.
Mm-hmm.
I read the theory very well.
Okay, I understand that you have followed books and it went good for you. Like you
yes.
understood the basic and that worked for your interview
yes.
part. Great.
Yes,
so your interviews will be online? Was it?
Yes,
you
it
know?
Was online. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Like we have to, before interview, we had to send some documents like my project, BSc project work, then
letter of recommendation
SOP,
and all
SOP,
that.
SOP, yes, yes, yes. All those things.
Okay. So majorly letter of recommendation and SOPs are the two things that
yes,
one
yes,
need to
yes.
care about.
But they also asked me what you did in your project. Like not many questions, but tell me the what your project, what you exactly
basic
did
overview.
Work on. Yes, the basic overview.
Okay. So great. And when you stepped into that interview virtual room, what was your feeling? How they started?
The beginning was not at all good, actually. My laptop suddenly stopped working. The moment
oh.
I entered the interview room, my Wi-Fi could not connect. So they called me from there. I was I'm joining through my phone. Then I can set up my phone and join. But a good thing was I was not nervous.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't get nervous. If I had gotten nervous, then I would have lost it. So,
mm-hmm.
but I was not nervous. So that was a good thing. So when I entered, they asked me to show my room if there was anything.
Mm-hmm.
Then I showed my room and my ID. All this was shown. And then they started asking me questions.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So did they ask you a mathematical problem to solve or anything
yes,
like
yes,
that?
Yes. They asked me to solve two quantum problems. The sir helped. They helped me a lot. They gave me the hints and everything they did. But I completed the problems. For two
mm-hmm.
quantum problems, then I was actually, in my SOP, I had written a little about superconductors. But in BSc
mm-hmm.
level, we don't study superconductors. So the teacher
mm-hmm.
asked me if I know about the BCS theory. So I don't
mm-hmm.
know that. So I told that
oh.
I don't know that. So that I couldn't answer. And I couldn't answer one question related to statmic. I don't remember exactly. It was something related to Einstein condensation. Actually, he asked me what is Einstein condensation? So I told that. And then
mm-hmm.
he asked me how it is related to superconductors. So I
oh.
had read about this, about the Cooper pair. I had not
mm-hmm.
studied, but I had read about it while researching and all. So I told about that. And then he asked me something related to chemical potential and that I couldn't answer. So this question
okay.
I couldn't answer. And then I was asked about OPAM. I was asked about OPAM, a question about OPAM. And an experimental based question. And in OPAM also at last, they took the interview for like more than an hour. Okay. And at last I was like, okay, I don't, like, it was a very easy thing. I could have done it, but at last it didn't came to my mind in an OPAM question. So,
okay. So basically, you know, they help you in the interview part and yes, you know, they leave you. And one should not also worry ki yaar mere ko questions nahi aaye hain kuch to kya pata mera selection now, but you know it happened with you.
Like, mere,
you didn't give the like, some question a... but it you know definitely yes, worked yes, for yes. you and you yes. got selected. Yeah, you were speaking yes. something.
It's like I have a friend and she was like she couldn't answer some questions and she thought she won't get selected, but she got selected. So they actually, I think they see how is your approach to the question. Like it's not that you always have to say the correct answer. I think they see the approach also. Like if it's correct, like they will take you.
Oh, okay. Great. Good to hear that. So can you give some tips for the new students who are preparing for JAM 2022 and, you know, TIFR 2022, how you can suggest them?
First, don't take so hard on yourself. Like if you work hard, you will do good. Okay. No matter what. One door closes. I also thought that after JAM nothing will happen, but it did happen. So if one door closes, another door will always open. So don't take so hard on yourself. And yes, like if you start JAM preparation from second year, it's really good. Like you should not start your JAM preparation 6 months before. It gets tough. You should start at least from second year.
Yeah, the beginning and of definitely, if your aim is to study physics, then it's good, yes. you know, start early and get the basics yes. of the physics. Yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. That I did. That was a mistake from my part. I took it very lightly initially. So that you should do. And like for me, classical mechanics, I didn't like classical mechanics. So I didn't do much good in that part. I still don't like classical mechanics. So like take some subjects, like you had also while teaching, you had also told that it's not necessary that you have to do all the subjects equally good. You should do 5 or 4 subjects nicely and work on it. So I did that.
Formulas for rest of them. If easy questions come, then you can face the easy one.
And yes, that's note making thing. Like I had 2 copies, like all where all the notes are written about all the subjects. That really helps, you know, like before every exam, I see those things.
Yeah, short
that
notes.
That really helps. Yes, short notes. Okay. Like because like before the interview, I had not studied electronics much. Okay. Mm-hmm. I had not looked after like electronics. So, but like I saw that copy of mine and in that copy, I've written everything like OPAM, all the subjects I've written about all the subjects. So since I had done revised those things, so like it was much easier for me in the interview also.
Okay. Great. Even I have that, you know, notebook still with me that I prepared for JAM and I still study on the daily, you know, every day. I must say I studied that every day for 15 to 20 minutes. It helps, you know, get a flow of physics. So that's really, really good for me as well. Okay, yes, great. Yes. Okay. Moving on to the next question. I would like to ask how, you know, like which teachers you followed and which books you followed.
I followed you I followed your Unacademy lectures and I saw some lectures of Amit sir also.
Okay.
So I followed Unacademy and then for 6 months, but not before TIFR because after JAM I was very heartbroken. I was like, nothing will happen. So after JAM I stopped watching lectures and I did saw some lectures from YouTube also. YouTube is also very helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Then for books, I did the CED and that like career endeavor and that physics notes. I did them. Solved all the examples and
study then, material helped you a lot. Like
yes,
basic
those
study
helped
material.
Me a lot. Yes, yes.
Yeah,
and then career endeavor had some test papers also of all the subjects. So I finished all of them before JAM.
Yeah.
That also helped me a lot.
Okay. Great. So did you know everything was in the notes? What do you think? Like how many? Yeah, I wanted to ask like how much notes helped you? You know,
like everything cannot be from the notes, that can't happen, but yes, notes obviously will help you. Like you should practice, right? Practice is the only thing that will help you. You cannot get the question paper beforehand, you don't know what will come, so the only thing you can do is practice. So yes, that helps a lot, and especially last year papers also help a lot. Like you get to know how the question paper is, how much time you are taking, so all those things help.
Okay, time management, it teaches you time management. Yes, the previous year questions. Great. And you are saying that notes and books are, you know, are really good things to do. Yes. Go for it. And the study material as well.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So one last question I would like to ask, what are your plans? Are you planning something before TIFR?
I got into the condensed matter physics department. So, okay. And I had not, it's not that I know a lot about condensed matter physics. I just know a bit about like superconductors and all those things. I was just reading about them. So I found those interesting, but let's see what happens now. Like, I don't know exactly what will happen.
Okay, great. So that's all. Let's end the recording. Okay. Hello, everyone. At this point of time, I would like to, you know, tell you something. अगर आप इनमें से किसी भी एग्जाम की तैयारी कर रहे हैं, चाहे वो IIT JAM हो, जेस्ट हो, TIFR हो, GATE, JNU, BHU, DUCE, कोई भी एंट्रेंस एग्जाम की तैयारी हो, तो आपके लिए बहुत सारे जो है फ्री कोर्सेज अवेलेबल हैं, ठीक है, इंडिया के बहुत अच्छे एक प्लेटफॉर्म पर जहां पर मैं पढ़ाता हूं, और करंटली मेरे को अभी तक 20 लाख मिनट से ऊपर बच्चों ने देख लिया है, एंड 4,78,000 मिनट्स मेरे को बच्चों ने इस मंथ देखा है, लास्ट 30 डेज, ठीक है, 2000 से ऊपर स्टूडेंट्स मुझे फॉलो करते हैं, ठीक है, एंड दिस इज माय प्रोफाइल, यू कैन विजिट, लिंक जो है नीचे है डिस्क्रिप्शन में. आई एम ऑल इंडिया रैंक 25 इन IIT JAM एग्जाम, MSc, IIT बॉम्बे, टॉप 1% NGP, गिवन 50+ सेलेक्शंस इन IIT JAM लास्ट ईयर, ठीक है, एंड बहुत सारे फ्री कोर्सेज अवेलेबल हैं, जैसे कि आप स्क्रीन पर देख सकते हैं. अगर आप मैथमेटिक्स करना चाहते हो, मैथमेटिकल फिजिक्स तो ये है, मैग्नेटोस्टैटिक्स है, सॉलिड स्टेट है, स्पेशल थ्योरी ऑफ रिलेटिविटी है, न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स, एटॉमिक फिजिक्स. अगर आप प्रॉब्लम क्लासेस करना चाहते हैं कि सिर्फ आपको प्रॉब्लम्स करनी है, थ्योरी नहीं करनी है, तो वो भी क्लासेस अवेलेबल है. अगर आप यूनिट वाइज टेस्ट देना चाहते हो तो वो भी अवेलेबल है यहाँ पर. तो आपको करना क्या है, इस लिंक पर जाना है जो कि डिस्क्रिप्शन में दिया हुआ है, और एक PDF खुल जाएगा, उसमें सारी मेरी क्लासेस के जो है लिंक्स अवेलेबल है, और ये एब्सोल्युटली फ्री है. अगर आप अनलॉक कोड यूज करते हैं Aurora10, ठीक है, साइन अप कर सकते हैं. पहले साइन इन करेंगे आप अपने नंबर से, लॉग इन करेंगे, एंड देन यू कैन वॉच फॉर फ्री दिस लेक्चर्स, ठीक है. सो दिस इंफॉर्मेशन मुझे देनी थी. हेलो एवरीवन, अगर वीडियो लगी है अच्छी और यूजफुल रही है आपके लिए, तो भाई लाइक में कोई भी कंफ्यूजी नहीं चाहिए, लाइक ठोक दो. सब्सक्राइब तो आप कर ही दे चुके हो, और ऑल्सो यार, अगर आप फ्री एजुकेशन को सपोर्ट करना चाहते हो तो जरूर इस वीडियो को शेयर करें अपने व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में, क्लास व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में, एज वेल एज अपने व्हाट्सएप स्टेटस में, ठीक है. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो.